Hi guys, welcome to a new video on the channel here. As you can see, I am editing the video right now, and I hope it's going to be I'm sure it's going to be a good video, so stay tuned for that. So let's torque them to spec. That's one. So now we have to try to lift it on the jack. A little bit. And that should be good. Maybe with a dolly. This is balancing. Okay. To the car. Okay. Okay. Take the screw out. Lay it on the ground. The other screw. Put it on the ground. There. And now we have to align the thing a little bit better. They get a bit better on the jack because it came a little bit off. Like so. A little bit better, like so, and now get it up high and see where it gets. Okay, you come here. That's a little bit more comfortable. And now a little bit more adjusting. Where is it? There it is. It has to come a little bit more this side. Okay, not easy. A little bit more to the left, like so. This one is nearly good. Like so, and like so, up high. Not good, not good. That's better. This not good there. It has to come down a little bit. Okay, not too much. Alignment and alignment. Not good, not good. It is not good. It has to go a little bit more to the right. Like so. A bit more. Bend down. Okay, stop. Jongens, jongens, jongens. There's no place for me to move here. Where is it? I just can't see it. I have to pause a little bit. Jesus. It is getting in, guys. It is getting on place. I think it is on place. It seems like it is. Yes, it's a 16. Okay. Get this one in place. Now on the other side. Okay. Now we should be able to lower the jack and take it away.
like so. And the differential stays on the car. And that's a good thing. Okay. So the U joints are working like they should. They don't hang. That's perfect. Also in this direction and in this direction. They work perfectly. They don't hang. They don't get stuck. Okay, that's a good thing. Now we have to put them back on.
So I will torque them later. But first, I'm going to reconnect the drive shaft. That's coming now. Okay, that is that. See, that was this one here. That is on. So, worst case scenario, there is one needle bearing that fell off. So we will have to see if all the needles are in there, and if they are not bent, clean it completely, grease it again and try to get it on. So let's do that. So they are all back in. Not one needle hit the ground, not one needle was bent. So now let's try to put it back on. So, needle bearings back on. Screws torqued for this drive shaft. And then half shaft on and screws torqued. Now we're going to spray some silicone to protect the rubber here and to make it easier to put it back on both sides here, like so. And now we can take it up. A little bit more silicone spray, like so, and then we can get it up high again. Put it here so you can see it. Back on both sides, and the markings are also back on place. Now we can put the leaf spring back on. Let's do it. Thank you. So before I put these Magnaflows back under the Corvette, I'm going to clean them. Because I want them to shine. So the last exhaust pipe is on. Now I have to fasten all the nuts and bolts and put it in the right position and fasten all these things here, and then we are practically done fixing the wheels and can take a test drive.
So I did a test drive.
If the crows can shut up. I did a test drive and right off the bat, it isn't fixed. So the diagnose of the yokes was wrong. My friend Ludo had a wrong diagnose, but I can't complain about that because it's a very difficult thing to diagnose. So what is wrong with the differential? I just can't say it. It locks. It locks, and on moments when the steering is completely to the right and I'm driving backwards and slowly parking, and then it locks, it loosens, it locks, it loosens, it locks, it loosens, and you feel it in your butt and you feel the whole car shaking, like if the I think the wheels are locking each other. So the spider wheels, I think that's the reason. I think I have to change them again. But that's for another time, because I've had it a little bit with the differential. I'm going to let it sit for a while and think about it. If there's anyone who can give me the right diagnosis and can help me with this problem, please let me know in the comments below. So for now, thank you all for watching. If you liked it, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't, let me know in the comments why. And find us on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. And I will see you in the next one. Peace.